Hello students, I Sneha Sharma, your English teacher, welcomes you to your English 2 class. Today, we will be starting chapter 15, that is the selfish giant. Okay, so here in this story, we will come to know about a giant, okay, and about his selfishness. Okay, so this story is written by Oscar Wilde. He was born in the year 1854. And died in the year 1900. Was an Irish novelist, short story writer, playwright and poet. A major celebrity in his time both for his personality and his art. Wilde was celebrated for his wit and the beauty of his language, both written and spoken. So he was a very famous person, a celebrity of his time because of the beauty of his language, his intelligence, both in the way he wrote or he spoke. In his plays, he tended towards social satire, while his short stories and famous novel, The Picture of Dorian Gray, often had a fable-like quality. So, small fables means small stories, short stories he used to write. He was mostly famous for short stories. Now, let us start with the chapter. So, every afternoon, as they were coming from school, the children used to play in the giant's garden. So you can see the children are playing in the giant's garden after they used to come from school. It was a large lovely garden with soft green grass. Here and there over the grass stood beautiful flowers like stars, and there were 12 peach trees that in the spring time broke out into delicious blossoms of pink and pearl, and in the autumn bore rich fruit. So it was a beautiful garden. There were almost how many peach trees? 12. And in the spring, it used to bloom with pink and white flowers. Okay. And during autumn, it used to bear fruit. The birds sat on the trees and sang so sweetly that the children used to stop their games in order to listen to them. So the children used to stop to listen to the sweetly singing birds. How happy we are here, they cried to each other. So the children were very happy playing in the garden. One day the giant came back. He had been to visit his friend, the Cornish ogre. What is the ogre? It's a monster in children's story who eats people, and had stayed with him for 7 years. So for seven years the giant was not at his home. He has not come to his garden. After 7 years he came back. After the 7 years were over, he had said all that he had to say, for his conversations was limited. So not a lot, he didn't speak much. And he determined to return to his own castle. So after spending 7 years with the ogre, he wanted to come back to his castle, come back to his garden. When he arrived, he saw the children playing in the garden. So what was the scenery that the giant saw? That children were playing in his garden. So what happens? What does he do? What are you doing here? He cried in a very gruff voice, and the children ran away. Gruff means in a rough and unfriendly way. This is my garden, the giant said, and I will not allow anybody to play in it but myself. So he didn't wanted anyone to be in his garden. So he built a high wall all around it and put up a notice board. So he boundaried the garden with high walls and wrote a notice saying trespassers will be prosecuted. So if anyone who enters his garden without permission will be punished. He was a very selfish giant. The poor children had now nowhere to play. They tried to play on the road, but the road was very dusty and full of hard stones, and they did not like it. The road was very dusty, there was stone on the road, so they did not like playing on the road. They used to wander around the high wall when their lessons were over, and talked about the beautiful garden inside. So when they used to come after school, when they used to pass through from those high wall garden, they used to think that how beautiful the garden was on the inside. How happy we were there, they said to each other. So they always said that how happy they were when they used to play in the garden. Then spring came, and all over the country there were little blossoms and little birds. So now the season changed and spring came. Only in the garden of the selfish giant it was still winter. So everywhere spring came, everywhere flowers blossomed, birds chirped, but the giant's garden had still winter. The birds did not care to sing in it as there were no children and the trees forgot to bloom. So since there were no children playing in the garden, the birds also stopped singing there. The trees forgot to bloom. Once a beautiful flower put its head out from the grass, but when it saw the notice board, it was so sorry for the children that it slipped back into the ground again and went off to sleep. So again, once that flower bloomed, then as he saw the notice board, there were no children playing in the garden, so it went back. The only people who were pleased were the snow and the frost. Spring has forgotten this garden, they cried. So we will live here all the year round. So this is the snow and the frost talking, that the spring has forgotten to come here, so we will stay here. The snow covered up the grass with her great white cloak and the frost painted all the trees silver. Then they invited the north wind to stay with them, and he came. So after the snow and the frost, the north wind also came. He was wrapping it in furs and he roared all day about the garden and blew the chimney pots down. So what are the chimney pots? A short white pipe made of baked clay or metal that is attached to the top of the chimney. So it blew so hard that it broke those chimney pots. Okay, so the north wind was very harsh. This is a delightful spot, he said. We must ask the hail for a visit. Now they are calling the hail, again the more dangerous one. So the hail came. Every day for 3 hours he rattled on the roof of the castle till he broke most of the slates, and then he ran round and round the garden as fast as he could. So the hail came, it again caused some destruction. What's a slate? A small piece of slate or similar material that is used for covering roofs. So to cover roofs, these slates are used. So what did the hail did? It broke it. It moved round the garden. He was dressed in grey and his breath was like ice. We are talking about the hail. The hail was covered in grey. I cannot understand why the spring is so late in coming, said the selfish giant as he sat at the window and looked out at his cold white garden. I hope there will be a change in the weather. So now he is thinking that why didn't the spring come to his garden? Why is there winter still? There must be some change in the weather. But the spring never came, nor the summer. So spring also didn't come, the summer also. The autumn gave golden fruit to every garden, but to the giant's garden she gave none. So what happened in the autumn? Everywhere there was fruit in everyone's garden except the giant's garden. He is too selfish, she said. So the autumn said that the giant was very selfish, so she will not give any fruit to his garden. So it was always winter there, and the north wind and the hail and the frost and the snow danced about through the trees. Okay, so they were having fun. North wind, the hail, the frost, the snow. One morning the giant was lying awake in bed when he heard some lovely music. It sounded so sweet to his ear that he thought it must be the king's musicians passing by. So one morning what happened? He heard something very beautiful to his ear while he was in his bed. It was really only a little linnet singing outside his window. So it's a small bird that was singing outside his window. But it was so long since he had heard a bird sing in his garden that it seems to him to be the most beautiful music in the world. So say he has not listened to a single bird over a long period of time. So this sound of the bird made him feel that this was the most beautiful music in the whole world. Then the hail stopped dancing over his head and the north wind ceased roaring, and a delicious perfume came to him through the open casement. So what happens? The wind stopped, the hail also stopped, and there was a delicious perfume. So what's a casement? A window that opens like a door. I believe the spring has come at last, said the giant, and he jumped out of bed and looked out. So he was very excited that the spring has come. What did he see? He saw a most beautiful, wonderful sight. Through a little hole in the wall, all the children had crept in, and they were sitting on the branches of the trees. In every tree that he could see, there was a little child. So, on every branch of the tree, there were children sitting. And how have they entered? Through a little hole in the wall. And the trees were so glad to have the children back again that they have covered themselves with blossoms and were waving their arms gently above the children's head. So now what has happened? The winter has gone from those trees and those trees were blooming. The birds were flying about and twittering with delight, and the flowers were looking up through the green grass and laughing. So now the scenery is completely changed. So the bird is flying, they were singing, the flowers were blooming in the garden. Okay, it was a lovely scene. Only one corner, it was still winter. So the corner where the giant was living, it was still winter. It was the farthest corner of the garden, and in it was standing a little boy. So it was a furthest corner and there was a little boy standing. He was so small that he could not reach up to the branches of the tree, and he was wandering all around it, crying bitterly. So the little child wanted to get on the tree, but he was so small that he was not able to get on the tree. So he was crying bitterly. The poor tree was still quite covered with frost and snow, and the north wind was blowing and roaring above it. So since the child was not able to climb that tree, the tree was still covered with frost and snow. "Climb up, little boy," said the tree, and it bent its branches down as low as it could. But the boy was too tiny. So the tree said that climb up, but the tree itself bended so much, but the boy was so tiny that he could not get up. And the giant's heart melted as he looked out. "How selfish I have been," he said. "Now I know why the spring would not come here. I will put that poor little boy on the top of the tree, and then I will knock down the wall, and my garden shall be the children's playground forever and ever." He was really very sorry for what he has done. So now this scenery melted the giant's heart. He realized that how selfish he was. So he decided to knock down the wall and let the children play in his garden forever. Okay, so we are going to leave the chapter till here. In the next class, we will do what happens next. Okay, does the spring completely comes to the giant garden or not? So that was all for today's class. Thank you.